Hey, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this particular video, I'm going to show you how to connect your phone camera to Vimeo. Now, I've done a couple of videos here on this my YouTube channel on how you can connect both your 4K camera, your Ultra HD phone camera to Vimeo, and you can go ahead and check out those videos as well. But in this particular one is actually another method that I'm going to share with you on how you can be able to connect your phone camera on Vimeo. I did a broadcast recently. I covered a program for a church recently, and I used just my phone and a proper camera to cover the whole program, and it was great. And from the clip you are seeing there on the Vimeo output, one is the proper camera while the other one is my phone, and you can hardly tell from the two of them the difference from the two of them, because the quality is clean. You can see there the quality is clean, so it's very difficult for you to know which one is the proper camera and which one is the phone camera. And how I did this, the setup and everything I did, is what I'm going to be sharing with you in this particular video. I split the screen, as you can see there, using the Vimeo Virtual. So you can also check out the description below where I drop a link to that video where you will learn how you can be able to split your screen on Vimeo, as you can see right there on the screen. You can see, so where you can also be able to do something like this. Okay, you can see it, and the quality is very much okay. So we're going to be doing this using the NewTek NDI app. So the name of the app is called NewTek NDI app, and this app is currently cost about $16 or $14 on Play Store, so you can buy it from there. But if you don't have the money, don't worry, click on the link I dropped in the description below to download that another version of the app free of charge without paying any money at all. So just click on the link I dropped in the description below, download the premium app free purchase already done for you, and you can be able to make use of it. Okay, so just go over, click on the link, and you get straight to the happymood.com website where you can see, and click on the download APK there. Okay, click on the download APK. I'm just going to wait for it to load. Don't click on the fast download. Okay, so click on the download button or the fast download. Click on the download button, and once it's load like this, okay, this is actually an outdated version of the app. Okay, so I've not been able to get the updated version, the latest version, premium version of it free of charge. Okay, so this is the outdated version, but you can also make use of it for this particular tutorial. This is what I use to cover this program you're seeing right there on the screen, and it was actually great. Okay, so this is what I used to cover the program, and it worked perfectly fine for me. So you can also make use of it as well. But if you have the money, go over to Play Store. You can just spend like $14 to be able to buy the app from Play Store. But if you don't, go ahead and download it. Okay, so I've also dropped the link in the description below, remember. So I'm just going to wait for it to load. Okay, so let's load it. I'm going to give us I'm not a robot thing, just tick that also. Let's select, say we should select bridge, just select bridge as well. Click on verify, and once you're done, you see the create download link there, click on it. And once you finish, you see the app is already downloaded. See it here, the NewTek NDI. So once you click on it, you should be able to install it on your PC. Allow, and this is the app NewTek NDI. So once you're done, go ahead and install it on your phone. Now once you're done installing this app on your phone, open it. Okay, so open it, and you see it here right here on my screen. Open it and make sure your phone and your PC also are connected to the same Wi-Fi. Okay, so once you've opened it, this is it, as you can see right there on the screen. Okay, so click on the center button, this white button you're seeing right there on the screen, click on it, and it will change to red. Now once it has changed to red, go over to Vimeo, click on the add input button here, click on the add input button. Once it loads, go over to NDI and desktop capture. So once you click on it, you can see pause A51 there. This is what I'm making use of. Now if your phone and your PC are not connected to the same Wi-Fi, you are not going to see it on the NDI option there. So bring this in, and you can see right there on the screen. Let's change this to myself. Boom, there you have it. Let me just position the phone. You can see how it's looking. So everything is looking perfectly fine, and there's nothing like drag. Everything is working perfectly fine, and you can move it far. Okay, you can move it far to use it to video other things, maybe your church, congregational, or everything. Okay, so you can use it, but use a very strong network so that the Wi-Fi won't cut off as you're moving it far. Okay, so you can just play around with it and do the color correction, upgrading, or color grading, or anything you want to do. Double click on it and go over to color correction. No, the color adjust feature there, and you can increase the saturation. Okay, increase the saturation a little bit. If you feel like the background is not white enough, you can increase that, and you can see how it has turned out to be.
Yes.
So it comes with audio too. So you don't need to bring in any external audio or anything. So it's not only sending the video from your phone to your PC, it's also sending both audio as well. Okay, so it's sending both video and also audio to your VMix software, and as you can see right there on the screen, and you can actually stream this live or broadcast it, record it, or use it for your own program as well. Okay, and it will work perfectly fine. Now if you want to use this on Zoom, or you can also use it on Zoom as well. Okay, so all you have to do is to open your Zoom app, and let me quickly show you that, how to use it on Zoom as well. Okay, so go over here and click on the external tab. Once you click on the external tab, open the Zoom app. Okay, open the Zoom app, and open the Zoom app. I'm just going to wait for it to load just a second. Okay, so once you're done, go over to settings here in your video and select here. Don't select the NewTek NDI video, nothing is going to show. See, it's going to be blank. So select VMix video, and as you can see me right there on the screen, you see. So I can actually use it to do my meeting on Zoom. So I'm using my phone as my main camera, and I'm bringing it in here down to Zoom. You can see right here on the screen, you see, and it's working perfectly fine. Okay, so if you don't want to do it like this, there's still another way you can also make use of it on Zoom as well. So all you have to do is to close this. I guess we're done with this now. So close this. Okay, so close this, and then go over to NewTek NDI. That's the NewTek NDI 2. This is the 2. It's called the NewTek NDI 2. Okay, so click on it. Click on the NewTek NDI 2. Once it opens, select the webcam input. Okay, so I've also dropped a link for you to download it in the description below. Okay, so once you've done that, click on here. This plus button, you're going to see it there with the webcam input to be saved right here. So to right click on it, go to localhost, and you see the port A51, which is my phone camera. You see, I've seen it there. Now once you've selected your phone camera, go ahead and open Zoom. Okay, go ahead and open Zoom. Okay, and once your Zoom is up, click on this setting sign here, and once it's up, go over to video and select the NewTek NDI video. And as you can see right there on the screen, is my phone camera, and I can actually use it to do my video. Now this will be sending both the audio from your phone and also the video as well, all to your PC, and you can use it to start your Zoom meeting as well. Okay, you see, and this is it.